Hello everyone, today we have new video review, and as you can see, this time we are going to talk about something different. This is a new release from Bulova. It is called as a Surfboard Edition. It is not difficult to guess that Bulova decided to remind us about its sport chronographs, which were released in 1970s. So this watch got its nickname from the fans during that time, and Bulova took it and used it on the new limited edition throwback, which is more or less similar to the original release. So first of all, here we get classic style, so it's a stainless steel case. And here we have this slightly extended shape, which looks really nice. It is not that huge on the wrist, and you can see it on the video. Case size is just around 40 millimeters in diameter, and it's 16 millimeters thick, so it should be okay for everyday use. It should be easy to hide under a sleeve, so I would say it's good everyday watch. Some might call it is a mid-sized watch. I would agree, because 40 millimeters is not that huge and it's not that small. But I think it might be a good looking watch for some women as well. I really like what Bulova did with this case here, because we do not have a lot of polished surfaces. Everything is combined in a really nice manner, and it's visible that there was some back thought behind this design. It wasn't just a blind copying of original styling. Everything here screams about its 70s roots. You can see the smooth lines on the edges, which slightly extend to the lugs. We have this really nice bezel. Pushers are as classic as they could be. So I would say it's a really clean cut composition, which should look good in every situation. What I really like in this design is this slightly curved sapphire crystal on the top. It adds this visual touch where we get these various image refractions under certain angles, and it looks really good. It reminds about classic watches. In my opinion, this is one of the main selling points for this watch. I wouldn't say that distortion is really crazy here, so don't worry, it won't influence everyday use, and it's easy to read time through such glass. There are four different color versions of this dial. There are four different color combinations, let's say. So as you can see, we have more or less classic combo, which looks really good, and it has this distinct symbol in the middle, this surfboard, which gave the nickname to this watch. I really like that it focuses your eyes on the two subdials. It's not an extra element, it's just sleek addition to whole design. It looks classic, and I would say it doesn't look extra on the whole dial. These hands have their own distinct design, which looks surprisingly good, even though they might look thick, but it's still easy to read the time with their help. Note that on different versions there is a white surfboard, let's say, so you have colors in completely opposite combination. This watch has surprisingly good lume covering, so we have it on indices and hands. You can notice on the video that second hand is also covered with lume, and it shines bright orange color, which looks surprisingly bright, so it will definitely come handy underwater. As far as I understood, bezel shape and color is standard for all four color combinations. So we have this Pepsi bezel with lume dot at 12 o'clock. It is rotatable in both directions, which is also surprising for a diving watch. So that's why I was saying it's not a serious diving watch. Note that here we have screw down crown, and I was really surprised, because usually, I mean, for me it is traditional to have a normal crown on chronographs, but here we have screw down, so it's a nice small touch which reminds us about diver watches. I guess it also had influence on the overall water protection, which is counted at 200 meters. Obviously, it's not a professional diver watch, but it should be enough for every use. For some 50 meters diving, it should be completely fine. Nevertheless, you can notice that chrono second hand is a sharp pointed hand, which looks really good. It's finished here in a bright orange. And the overall move of this hand is quite smooth, thanks to the quartz movement inside, but we will talk about this later. And the hour and minutes hands, they finished in white color, so it is easy to find them with help of huge indices, it will be really quick to know the right time at the moment. As I mentioned, we have quartz movement inside, it's a Miyota Caliber 6S21 chronograph movement, and it is not automatic, but I mean, it would be strange to expect something more serious with this price tag, and I think it should be handy for everyday use because it's a reliable movement which is used in many watches as well as Bulova watches too. Note that case back is full metal here, there are no transparent inserts. As you can notice, today's watch is combined together with black silicone strap. I wouldn't say that it's a bad option because it has this nice external design with an unusual finish on the top, but if you want to do something different, you can add NATO strap, of course, and have a fully classic diver combination on your wrist. Strap comes with double clasp mechanism, so it should be more or less reliable, and of course it is easier to handle such strap on your wrist. Price is set at $600 US, so I wouldn't say that it is cheap watch, but for something with classic design, with chrono functions, and also coming in 4 different color combinations, in my opinion it's more or less a reasonable price tag. So if you want something more streamlined, if you want something different from current offerings on the market, you definitely should check this watch from Bulova. It should be already available, as far as I know, Helvetia webshop has it for sale, so you can find link in the video description below. And of course I will be happy to hear your opinion about such watch, write it in the comment section. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for joining me today, I hope you enjoyed this video, and bye!